Hello guys and welcome to today's video. I just turned 27. It was my birthday 2 days ago. It's the 13th, is it? Yeah, it's the 13th of May today and my birthday was on 11th May. So I just turned 27, guys. I feel pretty old. I'm not gonna lie, but hey, I guess age is just a number. So yeah, I just turned 27 and I thought of sitting down and talking to you guys about my birthday, because usually I think ever since I was 24, I always vlogged my birthdays out here on my YouTube channel. So you guys have always been watching my birthdays since I was 24, and this birthday was slightly different because we're in quarantine, we're in self-isolation, so we didn't go out. Obviously I was just sitting at home. I spent my birthday with my family, so I thought of just talking to you guys about my birthday and telling you what I did, because I didn't vlog on my birthday. There wasn't really much to show you guys. All I did was basically ate a lot and spent time with my family, which is also very lovely. I think my birthday was really nice. But yeah, I'm basically gonna tell you what I did on my birthday while I do my makeup today, and this is the makeup look that I will be creating for you. I think it turned out quite nice. I'm quite happy with the way the makeup is looking. And yeah, also guys, before we get into the video, I want to quickly show you what I got for my birthday. Now obviously any gift, big or small, is super special. But this particular gift that I got is very special to me because of the way my mom managed to get it. The story behind the gift is very sweet. So this is something that I wanted a while back. It's from Louis Vuitton. And I actually went to the Louis Vuitton store with my mom a couple of months ago during my Roka period. And my mom noticed that I was looking at these earrings a lot. And I tried them on, but that I didn't buy it because I wasn't sure back then. And then these earrings became really popular. I don't know if you guys know the earrings that I'm talking about, but these earrings are really popular on social media, and I was like, damn, I think I want to get it. And I was just talking to my Louis Vuitton SA recently, and he told me that okay, these earrings are pretty much sold out, and the price is also increased now. So I was like, okay, I think I should have gotten the earrings. And then I found out that my mom actually had already bought these earrings for me back then, to give it to me on my birthday, which was so sweet. And then the lockdown happened, which is crazy, so I got the earrings anyway, which is a very special story. The thought behind it is very special. So yeah, I got these earrings from my parents. Let me unbox it for you. Obviously, I did already open it because I wanted to see what my mom got me. So it came in this box and in this dust bag. The earrings that she got me are these Louis Vuitton hoops, and I think they're so cool. They're these gold hoops. Guys, I wear gold hoops all the time. They're like the most staple piece of earrings that I can possibly have. So I love my hoops, and now the fact that I have these from Louis Vuitton, I think are very cute. So they're not also too in your face, because when you wear it sideways, the logo is not really seen. So I think it's a very cool piece of earring, and I feel like I'm gonna wear this a lot. And yeah, this is what she basically got me for my birthday, which is, I think, so sweet. So it's from my parents, obviously, mom and dad. Thank you so much. I love my new earrings, and I think they're very special. So yeah, this is what I got for my birthday. And besides that, obviously, I got lots of food and lots of love, lots of kisses and hugs from my family. So yeah, it was a very, very beautiful birthday overall. And I'm gonna stop talking. Let's get into the video and let's create this makeup look. Alright, so you guys have seen the makeup look that I'm about to create. Funny story, that's from the future, so I don't really know what makeup look I'm about to create. But yeah, I'm just gonna play, I'm just gonna wing it. Because guys, I have been super basic with my makeup so far. Ever since I started doing my makeup, I've been very basic when it comes to the colors that I choose and the, you know, the way I do my makeup. Like, I try to do what I know looks good on my face. So I haven't really experimented. Also, because of the fact that we lead such busy lives, we usually don't really have the time to experiment with our makeup. And now, since the time we've been in quarantine, we have all the time that we have. I have sort of revisited my makeup cabinets, and you know, I'm super lucky to basically get a lot of new launches from brands every other day. They keep sending me a lot of products. So now is the time that I get to experiment with all this makeup that I keep getting. And today I'm going to try and use a bit of color on my face. I saw this product from Huda Beauty last night that I had. It's their liquid eyeshadows, and I was very intrigued. It's this one. And I also picked out a color that I want to use for today's makeup. So yeah, I'll probably use this. I don't really know the right technique to use liquid eyeshadows because I haven't really used them before. But we'll see how it goes. And yeah, let's just basically have fun with the makeup. And while I do this, we'll chit chat. I'll tell you what my 27th birthday was like. So yeah, I think that'll be fun. So first I'm just going to dye my hair so that I don't have my hair in my face. Alright, so my face is super clean right now. I don't have any makeup on. I have just started with this Pixi Vitamin C Lotion. So this is what I use as my base. Like, I like to keep my skin moisturized before I start my makeup. So yeah, I have this on, and now let's start with foundation. I am using my Fenty Beauty foundation, the Pro Filter Soft Matte Longwear Foundation in the shade 280. I used to wear 240, I remember, and I recently switched to 280 because I feel like I got a bit of a tan from all the traveling that I was doing. So yeah, I have switched to 280. And I just have a little bit on my palm, on my palm, at the back of my hand. So, my 27th birthday. So guys, obviously it was a quarantine birthday. It's not a birthday that I've ever had before, like sitting at home. It was pretty different, but also at the same time, it was really nice because I was basically just with my family. And I feel like now that I'm getting older, I don't really find the need to go all out and party. I think the last major celebration I had was when I turned 25. You guys saw that I've been vlogging my birthday since I was, I think, 24, whatever. So you guys saw my 25th birthday. So that was like one of the major parties that I had. But otherwise, I haven't really been celebrating my birthdays as such. Like, I just like to go for dinners with Siddharth. So that is probably what I would have done if we weren't in quarantine. So the only thing that I missed in my birthday was having Siddharth with me, because it was very strange not to have him. But he basically still did whatever he could while he was sitting at home. Obviously, he felt really bad that he wasn't with me. But he got a cake delivered to my house that he basically made, which was so sweet. And he was just on the phone with me the whole time. His whole family called me from all parts of the world. He has family in Dubai, Australia. So everyone called me to wish me. So yeah, it was just a very low-key birthday with family. We ate a lot of food. My mom made a lot of yummy food, guys. Wait, I'm gonna open this. Yeah, I have a mirror. Oh, this is perfect. I have a mirror. My cupboard basically has mirrors on it, so I've just opened one door so I have a little bit of a better view. Yeah, so as I was saying, my mom made a lot of food. Like, literally for lunch there was Italian, there was Indian, and then again for dinner there was a lot of Indian food, so everything that I liked. My best friend Ruchi, which is again so sweet of her, so Ruchi never enters the kitchen. Like, that girl can't cook at all, but she basically made the effort to look up a cake video on YouTube, like how to bake a cake, and she baked a cake for me and made sure that I had it. She lives like two buildings away, so she came to the gate and she gave it to my sister-in-law, and she basically, yeah, gave the cake for me. So she baked a cake. So 12 o'clock when we were bringing in my birthday, I had a cake from Ruchi, which was so sweet. So my best friend baked a cake for me, my boyfriend's fiance baked a cake for me, and my mom also made a cake. So yeah, there were a lot of cakes, lots of food, and basically a lot of family time, which was perfect. So yeah, overall it was a really nice and chill birthday. The only thing that I missed the most was Siddharth. Alright, foundation is done. I'm not adding too much, guys, because it's quite hot. I don't have the AC on because my AC makes a lot of noise, so I'm just keeping it sort of light coverage, which is fine. We're going to focus on the eyes. Before we start with the eyes, I want to do my eyebrows, because my brows are very important to me. I feel like I can't look at my face until my brows are not done properly. So let's put some brows on. I'm just using my brow powder from Bharat & Doris, the eyebrow kit. This is my go-to eyebrow product. So I'm just going to fill it in. I go darker towards the end and lighter in the front. So that's what I'm doing. So guys, I want to know if you had a birthday in quarantine, if some of you have celebrated your birthday in these months. What did you do when you were in quarantine? Like, what was your birthday like? How old did you turn? if you're comfortable sharing your age. I turned 27, as I just said, and oh my god, I feel so old. I know I shouldn't say that. I feel like as I'm growing older, I'm a little more in control of my life, which is good. But also, I feel like as you grow older, there are so many more responsibilities. You know, when you're younger, you're just so much more free. You're more free to sort of do tiny mistakes, and it's okay because you're young. But when you're older, it's just a little more, I don't know, scary. So yeah, it's a little scary to grow older. I feel like now that I'm 27, I'm like a proper adult. I always was an adult ever since I was 18, but yeah, now I'm like literally in the adult category, which is, yeah, just so strange. Because I've always been the youngest in my house till the time Diva came. So I was always used to being treated as the kid, as the child at home. And now that I'm 27, I'm just like, whoa, that's like a lot. So yeah, I feel old for sure. But I mean, hey, age is just a number, I guess. And yeah, I'm just still trying to digest the fact that now I have to say 27 when people ask my age. But yeah, brows look fine. I'll probably just add a bit of concealer later below my brows, but... And also, I'll use the concealer later after I do my eyeshadow. I usually use my Fenty Beauty Concealer, but I'll use this after I do my eyeshadow because usually I end up dropping a bit of eyeshadow here, so we've cleaned that up. So now let's move on to eyeshadow. So first, I'm just using my BND Loose Powder and placing some of the powder under my eye so that it can catch any eyeshadow that falls, and also like the baking bit. It can do that for a bit. I don't really bake as such, but just under my eyes, I try to put some powder when I'm doing my eyeshadow so that it's not a mess once I'm done. So now let's move into eyeshadow. First, I'm just going to start with some basic browns, some nice neutrals to sort of smoke up my eyes, and then I'm going to add the green. So to start with, I'm using this palette from MAC, which is Amber Times 9. I think I've used this palette a million times on this channel. You guys have seen it so many times, but I love this palette. This is what it looks like. And I'm just going to start with... I think I'm just going to start with a bit of the brown here. Just gonna start from the corner, go darker here and then lighter as I go in. I feel like those earrings are super trendy right now. I'm so glad that I got them because I spoke to my SA from Louis Vuitton, Priyam, and he was telling me that those earrings are pretty much sold out in Mumbai right now. And the pair that I got was the last pair. And also the price of those earrings apparently went up because right now it's a very popular piece. So I'm very happy that I got it. I'm just going to use the fluffy brush to sort of blend it in. Alright, I'm going to clean a little bit. That's falling down. Now, I'm going to go in with a lighter shade, which is this one up here. I'm going to place it in the middle. So guys, what do you think about this whole lockdown thing again? Like, have you all gotten used to being at home? What is life like right now? I want to know. I mean, for me, I feel like it's become a little monotonous for sure, just like everyone else. But I feel like I've also been really productive during this whole period. I've been rolling a lot of content hours out. I'm sure you guys noticed that. Like, I feel like I'm getting a lot more time to do my own content. Because before... Let me just place this quickly. So, I feel like, yeah, I have a lot of time now that I'm home because, you know, I would have to travel a lot. I was working with a lot of brands on projects because at the end of it, that's a huge part of what I do. Working with brands, you know, to sort of obviously make a living. So I was very busy and occupied with those projects, and now that I'm home, I'm obviously being able to shoot a lot more for you guys, you know, and being able to do a lot of my own content. So what do you guys think about that? Like, are you guys happy that, you know, the content creators that you follow are being able to do a lot of their own stuff? But also at the same time, now that it's been over 2 months in quarantine, I am sort of not being able to be as creative because I feel like there's only so much you can do when you're home, because obviously in India you're not even being able to shop, right? Like, a lot of the content creators abroad are being able to shop and do haul videos for you still, but in India And also where I'm living right now is a red zone. I can't really buy products and show you those products in haul videos. So there's only so much I can do. There's either makeup that I can do, fitness videos that I can do, or just like talk. But there's not a lot that I can still do. So I am sort of running out of ideas, and I don't just want to roll out videos here just for the heck of it. I hope you guys understand. So yeah, I did tell you in the beginning that I will be following a schedule of Wednesday and Saturday, but now I'm not able to do that because there are times when I just don't have good enough ideas to sort of execute. So as in when I know that I want to do something, I do it. So please excuse that. I will try and post as much as I can, but I'm only going to post videos that I'm proud of. I don't know if you guys noticed, but I always get oily around this area, like super easily. So I always have to powder that area. I just applied my foundation and I'm already getting oily here, which is a problem no matter what foundation I use. I don't know why that is. Alright, now it's time for some color. I'm gonna get this little eyeshadow bad boy out and I'm gonna try the color. I think I'm gonna go for the glitter side of it. There's a matte green and there's a glittery green. So I think I'm gonna use the glitter just right here. I'm just gonna place it right here and see what that looks like. I don't know, guys. In case it doesn't look good, please excuse me, but I'm still gonna try. What I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna place the glitter and then use my fingers to sort of blend it in. So let's see how that looks. Okay, I'm gonna look here because I don't want to mess it up. Wow, guys, this is super pigmented. Like, wow, just like two strokes and I have so much color. So I think I'm just gonna work with a little bit first before I add some more. Okay, but I feel like my finger is sort of eating up the glitter, so I need to add some more. But I love the way it looks. I feel like it's a beautiful pigmented shadow. I just added a little bit and then sort of went in with my fingers. I think I'm quite happy with the way it's looking. Now I'm just gonna go back in with the shadow and make it a little even. Guys, I have this green eye pencil which is brand new from this brand called Poly Glow. You know what? I think I need some wipes. I'll be back because I just need to clean my hand first. I have makeup all over my hands. So let me clean that out. Oh, these wipes are quite nice. Just removed everything super easily. It's from Kaya. I have these Kaya face wipes. Now, I think I'm gonna go ahead and use this green pencil to intensify this look a little more. And what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna sort of just use it as a thin liner and then see what that looks like. I think it looks quite nice. Do you guys think I should go all the way inside or just keep it on the outside? I think I'm just gonna sort of keep it till here because I don't wanna go overboard. So I'm just gonna keep the wing as a green liner and just keep it this side. And then on my lower lash line, I'm just gonna sort of smoke it up with the brown that I used earlier. I think I'm gonna go for the darker brown, which is right here, and then smoke it up a little. Alright, I think I'm quite happy with the way it's looking. Now I'm just gonna use some concealer under my eyes to sort of clean out the edges. And some of this, and then I'm gonna go ahead and use some mascara. Guys, fun fact, I have no clue how to use lashes. I still need to learn. Like every time I tried using lashes on my own, it was a big fail. Also, to be fair, I never really tried using lashes enough because I always just prefer wearing mascara. And recently I had been getting my lash extension, so I never really had to wear mascara or lashes, but now they've all fallen off. So I do need my lash extensions back, but I don't think that's gonna happen for a while because now obviously I'm not gonna walk into a lash studio because it's not safe. So I'm just gonna work with mascara and hopefully learn how to use lashes because I have so many nice ones at home that I want to try from all the brands that have sent lashes over. So I'm gonna try using lashes, but until then, mascara works. Also, I just used the concealer from Fenty Beauty, the Pro Filter Concealer in the shade 240. This was my earlier foundation shade and now I've moved up to 280, as I told you earlier. But I'm still using the lighter concealer because I feel like that still works. Also, my thoughts on the Huda Beauty Liquid Shadow. I feel like it was quite nice. It's super pigmented. I feel like I still need to learn the right technique to use it. But I feel like fingers obviously still work because I don't think it would work with a brush. So I still need to experiment a lot more with them. I'll probably do it a little more and then do a video. But first impressions, I feel like it's quite nice. It's quite pigmented. You can really do a lot because the color really shows. Gonna use a little concealer under my brows as well. What shows have you guys been watching? Guys, oh my god, okay, there was this show that I watched last night and obviously I binge watched it. I finished the whole season. There's only one season that's come out so far on Netflix. It's called Into the Night and oh my god, guys, trust me when I say this, you need to watch that show. Like, it blew my mind. It's about a flight that gets hijacked and it basically is trying to run away from the sun. You guys should totally watch it. I'm not gonna tell you the whole story because I feel like it won't be fun for you if I tell you everything. But yeah, you should totally watch it. I feel like it was a very gripping show. It's just 6 to 7 episodes, so you can easily finish it in one go if you're like me. But yeah, I really like that show. I literally messaged on my friend's group chat and I told everyone to go watch it because it was really good. Alright, time for some mascara. I switch between two mascaras, let me show you. So recently I've been switching between two mascaras. One is my Lash Sensational mascara from Maybelline. This one I've been using for years. I absolutely love it. And recently I've also been using Better Than Sex from Too Faced. This mascara has also been amazing. So I'm gonna use this one again because this one's getting a little old. I need to open my new pack. Because I have a lot of these in stock, but I'm gonna use this one. Before that, I'm gonna use my eyelash curler. I am super scared of these, especially when a makeup artist does this on me. Like, I freak out. Like, I'm still okay when I'm doing it on myself, but when I'm on shoots and if there's an artist that's doing my makeup, I get really scared when they sort of come close to my eyes. I'm always like, ah, don't kill me. So yeah, although it is a very important step. Honestly, I wanted to talk to you guys about my 27th birthday because I always... So first of all, I didn't vlog on my birthday because there wasn't really much to show you because the only thing that I was doing was eating. So obviously there wasn't much to show you because I wasn't doing much. I was just sitting and talking to my family, eating, talking, eating, just that basically. So there wasn't really much to vlog. So I thought, okay, I'll just sit down and talk you guys through my birthday. But to be fair, I didn't really do much. I don't really know what to tell you besides what all I ate. So I'm sorry if this video is not very informative about my 27th birthday. So one of my friend got married on... she got married in this quarantine phase and I'm so happy for her. Megha, I love you. I'm so happy. You look so beautiful. And I actually saw her wedding on Zoom yesterday. So she invited all her friends on a Zoom call and obviously she only got married with her family members around and it was such a beautiful wedding. She was meant to get married in April and that couldn't happen because of the lockdown. So she got married at home and she made such a beautiful bride. So yeah, congratulations Megha and Tushar. I'm so happy for you guys. And it was a very beautiful wedding. So yeah, that also happened. I attended a wedding in lockdown through a Zoom call, which is crazy. Yeah, that also happened. Now I am pretty happy with my eyes, so I'm not gonna go too crazy. I think I just want to use some liner in my waterline on top, not on the bottom. The other end of the Bolliglow green liner is actually a black one, so I'm just gonna use this one. It's actually quite nice. I really liked it. I'm just gonna use on top. I feel like this step is worth doing because it really opens up your eyes. It makes it look bigger. So I like using a black liner on top in my waterline. Now time for some contouring, highlight, blush, all the good stuff. For the contour, I'm gonna use my Smashbox Studio Skin Shaping Foundation and Contour Stick. So I'm just going to use the contour side of it. In case you're wondering, I have shade 2.2 with me. And I don't want to contour this part because I feel like when I use my blush, it does the job. So I only contour usually on my nose. Do I have a thinner nose now? No? I tried. Okay. Now I am going to use some blush. And I have the Too Faced Papadone Peach with me, which is a nice peachy color. So for my lip, I think I'm going to do a nice nude brown. So I feel like a nice peach would look good with this look. Get some. Lots of it. I like lots of blush, which is why I didn't do the contour, because then it gets too brown. So I'm just going to go crazy with blush. Smile and apply. This blush actually also has a bit of shimmer, so you can totally skip using a highlighter if you use this blush, which I usually do. I like to use lesser products usually, like I don't like to have too many products on me, especially when I'm trying to do my makeup quickly. So with this blush, I usually skip using a highlighter. Yeah, I feel like the peach looks really nice with the green on my eyes. Oh, I think the only thing that's left is my lip. Which lip color should we use? I think I'm going to use this beautiful brown from L'Oreal, which is called I Lead. It's their new liquid lipsticks. I actually did a campaign with them for this one and I really like it. Yeah. Again, guys, I don't really line my lips. I do sort of sometimes overline my lips with the lipstick itself. But I usually don't use a lip liner. I don't know why. I just like using lesser products. And I feel when you overline your lips with a lipstick, it sort of does the job. So I don't really end up using a lip liner. What do you guys think? Okay, I think it looks really nice. I'm pretty happy with the makeup. I think I just want to quickly powder a little right here, because I told you I get pretty oily on my T-zone. I think I'm pretty happy with the way the makeup has turned out. What do you guys think? Alright, I'm ready now. Where are we going? Should I call the taxi? Are we going out? No? Okay. Either way, I'm still ready. So guys, this brings us to the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed watching me create this makeup look. I think it turned out quite nice. I like it. It's not too crazy, but I still really like it. I also enjoyed talking you through my birthday, my 27th birthday. Although I didn't do much, I think it was very special and I will always cherish that day. It's going to be a very memorable one. It's gone down in the history that I had a birthday in lockdown, which is crazy. So yeah. And in case you guys have celebrated your birthday as well during this period, or in case your birthday is just about to come, a very happy birthday to you. I love you guys and hang in there. I hope you guys are doing well during this difficult phase of our lives. And yeah, I will see you guys soon. And I love you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in.